Good evening, doctors. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and today I am going to explain you the right bundle branch block interpretation lecture. So firstly, we have to be very much clarify what is the definition of right bundle branch block. It is the heart band blocks of electrical conduction system. It is known as the right bundle branch block definition. And what kind of causes which cause the right bundle branch block is myocardial infarction, congestive heart failure, electrolyte imbalance, hypoxia, atrial septal defect, ischemic heart disease, rheumatic heart disease, myocarditis, cardiomyopathy, hypertension, Brugada syndrome, ventricular pacing and ventricular rhythms. Now I am going to explain you how does this all affects on right bundle branch. Firstly, we have to know the normal physiology. How? Okay. Then what happens? SA node. SA node located here in the right atrium. Then what happens? The SA node gives impulses to the right atrium and left atrium. Then what happens here? There is a right atrial and left atrial depolarization occur and repolarization also, and then through AV node it goes to the bundle branch. Then bundle branch divided into right bundle and left bundle branch, and then to the Purkinje fiber. Then left ventricular depolarization occurs and right ventricular depolarization occurs after that. But what happens here in case of right bundle branch block? There is a blockage guys. Here there is a big blockage here in right bundle branch. It explain block, it's block. If this is not working branch, what was going to be happen? If this is not working, what is going to be happen? So pathophysiology, SA node, I already explained. Then right atrium and left atrium depolarization occur, which makes the P wave, and repolarization also occurs, but it's not visible on ECG. Then what happens? The conduction goes to the AV nodes, and AV nodes after right bundle branch block and left bundle branch. Here right bundle branch, but here the block in right bundle branch. So right ventricle receive conduction from the left myocardium. So the right ventricle here receive conduction from where? From the left myocardium. So what happen? It causes delay. So in V1 there is a wide QRS complex. There is a wide QRS complex due to right ventricle. And left side all is normal. This side is all is normal. All is well because there are no block in left bundle. But right bundle there is a block. That's why what happened? The myocardium of left ventricular supplies the conduction to the right ventricle. And it causes the delay. Delay. That's why there is a widening of QRS. And now how to interpret ECG of right bundle branch block. So I'm going to explain right bundle branch block ECG. There's a wide QRS. QRS must be more than 120 millimeter per second. So small r, s and capital R in lead V1. So we can see right bundle, there is a V1. We see the M pattern in V1. See, this is M pattern, small r, capital S and capital R. This is M pattern. But in case of V6 lead, we see the W pattern. See, this is looking like W and slurred S. Remember guys, I already explained here slurred S in V6. So see W pattern in V6 in case of right bundle branch. But in case of left bundle branch, it is reverse, vice versa, W in V1 and M pattern in V6. So what happens? So you remember this one. I'm going to explain you now ECG also, beta, mean, and that ECG will help you how to interpret this right bundle branch block. So see guys, here this is the ECG in book. See, this is V1. I hope it's visible. This is V1, see M pattern here, M pattern, M in V1, and V6 we see W pattern. See, this is W, myelin ECG. So this is right bundle branch block. I explained this in a book. So see, you can solve any questions from this now. And how to treat? And in V1 there is a terminal capital R wave. So see terminal capital R wave here. and sludge S wave in V6. So remember this formula, and V5 also we can see sludge S wave and V6 also, and this we can see amp pattern in V1 and V2 also. So don't worry, but in case of left bundle branch block, there is a vice versa. So treat the cause. Otherwise, cause, as I already explained, if MI, you need to treat MI. If there is a CHF congestive heart failure, like left ventricular failure, right ventricular failure, you have to correct this situation. If electrolyte disbalance, you have to correct electrolyte disbalance. If there is a hypoxia, you have to correct, give oxygen. If there is an atrial septal defect, you have to close the heart hole. Myocarditis and infection, antibiotics. Then hypertension, you have to treat hypertension. And ventricular arrhythmias, you have to treat arrhythmias. So if patient mostly asymptomatic, so otherwise no need any kind of treatment, only reassure the patient. In case of right bundle branch block, friends, you have to reassure, only nothing else. So remember one thing, in V1 we see the M pattern, V6 we see the slurred wave or W pattern. So my dear doctors, if you still not subscribe my channel, so please subscribe it and see your bell, put the click on that bell also. If you like my channel, please put like on it, and if you have any comments, any queries, you can ask me. Okay, thank you, that's all, have a good day and nice to